go.
Just imagine this. You're sitting in bed days or maybe even weeks now. You don't even know. And you're just trying to get over this sickness that you don't even...
You don't even know if it's severe or not. You're just trying to get over it. So you and your family decide to go on this journey for you to go to this free medical center because your family does not have enough money to go to the regular hospital and get checked up and get your medicine. So you finally go to the free medical center and you get your medicine, all that stuff, and you go back home. This might take like a week or so. So this is what people in Kenya or in third world countries have to do when they're sick. So after listening to many, many testimonies from my friends and family at church back home of them going to Haiti or Kenya or all these third world countries, I've been inspired to take action and just talk more about what they've encountered and what health is like. So to narrow it down more, I'm going to talk more about the health in Kenya. And most people in Kenya suffer mainly from four things, and they are cheaply prevented illnesses, water, cleanliness, difficult pregnancies, and pollution. These four might not seem very, doesn't mean much to us, but it hurts their health a lot in Kenya, especially for those who are 5 years old and younger, and for women. And so the first is cheaply prevented illnesses. So according to an article by 80,000 Hours, this is in general, so said that around 10 million people in poorer countries suffer from cheaply prevented illnesses. That could be HIV, the flu, or just common things. And with those 10 million people, they also suffer from undernutrition, so they are less physically and mentally capable to do their regular activities. So this is really sad. And so another thing what causes them to suffer from cheaply prevented illnesses is because they don't have adequate hygiene. So according to an article from Karen Freeman, she said that around 90% of diarrhea is attributed to unsafe water and poor hygiene. And the number one related cause of hospitalization is wash-related items for everyone, and especially for those who are 5 years old and younger. Living in a first world country, we really take for granted like having soap. It's always there for us. It feels like we never run out. But for these people in Kenya, they don't have soap. They have limited amounts of hygiene products. So when they eat, they take in a lot of bacteria, and that's what causes them to get sick a lot. So the next is water cleanliness. Water cleanliness might not seem really impactful to us because we can just go to the sink and just drink water or the water fountain. But for the people in Kenya, it's very hard for them to get water, and many children die from not having clean water every day. So according to an article from Water Project, it says that Kenya has had water scarcity for decades now. So they don't have clean water to drink for many, many years. And one of the reasons why is because Kenya does not provide equitable delivery of water to these water basins because the government does not want to pay for the gasoline for these water trucks like here, and they don't want to pay for the maintenance for these trucks when they break down. But when the water trucks do get to the water basins, they're really far away from all the villages because all the villages in Kenya are sporadic, so these families have to travel very far to get to these water basins. And according to this book Mwalimu's Dreams, written by her, so Mwalimu Carissa, she's from Kenya and she moved to America later on in her year. She said that, "One thing I noticed is the Americans have an abundance of drinking water. This is not the same for my country. We don't have clean water to drink in my village. The lack of safe drinking water in Africa causes many severe problems, including diarrhea and diseases. The water shortage in my country means many women and children spend one third of their day getting water." So this is very, very sad because imagining your kids just instead of going to school and getting their education, they have to spend one third of their day getting water for their family so they can drink clean water for the rest of the week or the rest of the 2 weeks. So clean water, it hurts a lot of lives in Kenya, just because they don't have enough of it. And the next is difficult pregnancies. But before I start to talk about difficult pregnancies, a data from World Book Data says that The average lifespan of United States people are around 77 years old, and the average lifespan of Kenyan people are around 66 years old. So that's an 11-year difference, and the main reason why is because of these difficult pregnancies. So according to CNN, there's this article about this lady right here. She had to travel 300 miles just to get to this free medical center so that she can give birth for, like, she didn't have to pay for any of her bills because she didn't have enough money. So just imagining her traveling 300 miles just to give birth, that's very devastating. But being pregnant in Kenya is also very, very, very dangerous, mainly because, according to CNN, 135 times women are 135 more times greater to die in pregnancy compared to the U.S., and every 1,000 births, around 38 mothers die in Kenya. And the main reason they die is because during pregnancy, mothers get sick really easily, so they don't get the medical attention or the medicine that they need. So that's very, very sad for these mothers to die during birth, and their kids, their babies not being able to see their mothers. And the last is pollution. So the main, pollution is a big deal around the world, but it's really, really bad for these kind of countries that are trying to industrialize fast, like Kenya. So that's one of the main reasons why, trying to industrialize quickly. So all these, according to CNN, one out of every four deaths is because of these chemicals that the factories are emitting. So, and the people are breathing them in, so that's also very bad. And according to an article from Daily Notion, around 14,300 people die from pollution every year. And that's mainly caused because they have very old cars, and a lot of them, and they don't take care of those cars. So all the CO2, or all the like bad air coming out of those cars, people are just intaking them in and just doing nothing about them. And the main source for fuel for food at, like, when you cook for them is still, it's wood and kerosene, like the gas. So using wood and kerosene is very bad for the families in general. So that causes them to have a shorter lifespan too. So what can we do as as people who live in first world countries? We can sign up with Team World Vision. I've done this before. It's basically raising money up for you. So it's basically your $50 equals water for life for children in these third world countries. And you run a 5K marathon or a whole marathon with this organization. Or you can donate to, or you can sponsor a child through sponsorthechildren.com, which is $1 a month or less, which gives them the basic necessities to, like, the nutrition, the hygiene, everything. And, or the easiest thing to do is to go to juglifewater.com, which is an organization started by, if you guys know, JaVale McGee from the Golden State Warriors and other actors and athletes who spreads the news of the importance of drinking water. And you can just go to juglifewater.com and to donate. And their main cause is building water wells in these third world countries, so like Kenya. So it's really easy. I've done it before. I have some of their merch. It's pretty cool. Kenya, and not only Kenya, suffers from all these, from cheaply prevented illnesses, water cleanliness, pregnancies, or pollution. Not only Kenya suffers from those, but all these third world countries also suffer from them too. But your donations might seem very little to you guys, but it's the world for these people. And every year, their lifespans have been getting better and better because of our donations and our help and our government funding in helping them out. So as Melinda Gates once said, government funding that's coming from the United States is making a huge difference on the ground in the developing world.